Hello everyone, and welcome to Train Sim World 3, where today we are going to be designing a new livery for Train Sim World 3's Acela. Alright, so we're going to go into the Acela and create, and we're going to call it... Why is my keyboard not behaving itself? Australia. Alright. Cool. So, what I was thinking of doing was painting it bright white. So what I want to do here, that's just the reflection of the I need to edit that. Cool. And this will be going up onto the content library as well, so you'll be able to download this. Hang on, I need to copy you, edit. So I might just shrink it down. Hang on, I just want to do it like that. Do is if I copy you and then group you together, and I copy you again. Cool. Edit, copy. I know they're a little... Yeah, hang on. I just want to... Hang on. Yeah, that's good. Cool. Yep. Cool. Okay, so... Cool, text. All right. Okay, so that's now done for both A and B. Now just do the first car. Okay, so what I want to do is paint every other car. Cool. So, hang on, let me just, I want to save that. Cool. I'll just give it a test run. Scenario designer. Let's go on the rapid transit. Acela. Ah, can't do that one. Okay, back. Let's go. Great Eastern then. Start this thing again. Okay, yeah, hang on. That would be good if I actually tilting is enabled, cab ceiling light is on. No, that's not what I want. No, hang on. Now let me just, give me a sec, restart, yes. I've got to stick it into neutral, then go to forwards, that's right. Okay, that's better. Okay, so it's going to reading. Pantograph is up. Cool. I loved driving the Acela back in the old days. Release the brakes. Thank you. So you guys know there's no actual tilting on the actual power car. It's done on the actual... these ones here. Let me just zoom in a little bit. So these ones here, so the cabs, or the rail cars rather. Actually, before we do that, I need to settings, HUD and gameplay, and I want measuring units, I want metric E. Yeah, the Acela doesn't really pick up speed very fast. It's a very gradual machine, so it doesn't like to do things as fast. Where the TGV has a more gruntier approach, it's like, we're going to go get here, and we're going to go at speed. So... I just want to see how fast this thing can really go. I know I'm breaking the speed limit, but we're on, we're just testing out the Acela on the ride, and we'll do some journeys with it and do some timetable missions and stuff. See how it tilts? So the cab cabins, the rail cars rather, actually tilt, not the actual power car. Passenger cars, that's the word I'm thinking of. Oh, it does tilt a little bit. But the other cars actually tilt more. Here, I think. See how it's tilting? Oh, this is new. I haven't seen this bit before. And that's where so that's the bell. What's that do? No motion bypass. Inhibit. Okay. Snow brake on. Can't do that one. Okay, let's have a look at, hang on. Is it that way? This way. Okay, let's have a quick look at the train. So the ditch lights are on as well. And then, got the, oh, wow, that's pretty fast. I thought it was a bit slower than that. Wow. And then if we press Shift P, I think it is. So that's how you do that. Let's have a look around the cab. So we can open that up. We can't walk all the way down there. We only can do certain things. A load of cutout. Okay. So if you were to go down there, that's where all the electrical stuff would be. And the door would open like that, and yeah. Cool. Cool. Okay, we're in forward, that's fine. Okay, you can hear the circuit breaker turning on. Press any of these buttons. Oh, hang on. I can't do that. Okay. Tilting is enabled, console dimmer. Okay. Let's have a look. Cab heater's on, defrost. Can't use any of those yet. Why is the BC still on? That's better. Now we're going to move again. Cool. So basically we've done an emergency stop, but it took me a while to work out how to get the brakes to come back on. All right, so that concludes this episode, ladies and gentlemen, and I will see you again shortly.